You know, what is the list? That is the main quotient. And answer is including this quotient. I think, you know, we are labor abundant country. So if one tourist come in Bangladesh, international tourist, it will create 11 jobs. It is UNWTO statistics. So we can create employment parallelly with the garment industry. So I think we have a great potential to establish, revisit our tourism industry. If you can invest more money in this industry, we can create more job. And it is 100% value addition. We will not import any ingredients from outside. Everything, we create our home, we create our vegetables, food, and rickshaw puller, and everything we create within ourselves, this country. So this is the 100% value-added industry, the tourism. I think we can focus our investment to the tourism as well as ICT.
আমরা চাই যে এটা কমে আসুক, অন্যদের এক্সপোর্ট বাড়ুক, তাহলে বোঝা যাবে যে অন্যগুলি মানে এক্সপোর্ট ডাইভার্সিফাইড হচ্ছে।
আপনি
বলতে পারেন পার্সেন্টেজ বেড়ে আসুক,
আমি সেটাই বলছি। আমি একটু বলে এটা দরকার আছে আপনাদের জানার জন্য। সরি ফর ইন্টারাপশন, ওয়াই আই এম ওয়ারিড, ওয়াই উই আর ওয়ারিড, বিকজ আমরা গার্মেন্টসের জন্য এত যে এক্সপোর্ট আছে, সবাই আমরা কিন্তু এইটা নিয়েই কথা বলছি, এই সেক্টর নিয়ে কথা বলছি। এই জন্য বায়াররা বলছে তোমার দেশে কিছু হলে তোমার তখনই এটাকে মিডিয়াতে চলে যাচ্ছে, টকশোতে চলে আসতেছে সব। আমি একটা ছোট একটা উদাহরণ দিই, আমার কাছে একটা পেপার আসে, পেপারের মধ্যে লেখা একটা আছে, গার্ডিয়ান পেপারে লিখেছে বাংলাদেশ ডার্ক স্যাটানিক মিলস, খুবই খারাপ জিনিস লিখেছে কিন্তু, নাম্বার ওয়ান। আমি জাস্ট বলছি এটা তো বিদেশিরা লিখেছে, আমরা বলছি আমাদের দেশের অনেক বড় বড় অনেকে বলছেন মজুরি না দেওয়া মালিকদের প্র্যাকটিসে পরিণত হয়েছে। আবার বিভিন্ন গোল টেবিলে বলা হচ্ছে তোবা গ্রুপের মালিক দেলওয়ার হোসেনের পক্ষে বিজিএমই কেন দাঁড়াচ্ছে, সে প্রশ্ন তোলা দরকার। তা আমি কেন বলছি এগুলোকে মানে এত বেশি নেগেটিভ করছে, কারণ যেহেতু হয়েছে কি ফ্যামিলিতে যদি কেউ বেশি ইনকাম করে বা বড় ভাইটা যদি হয় যে সব কিছু কিন্তু তারাই সব দোষ করে সবাই ধরে, কিন্তু তা আমাদের এই অবস্থা হয়েছে যে সব কিছু ফ্যামিলিতে একেই ধরছে। আসলে একে যদি বেশি ধরা হয় এটা যদি পড়ে যায় আর কোন সেক্টর।
থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ মিস্টার ইসলাম,
বলছি সবাইকে নিয়ে কাজ করতে।
থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ মিস্টার ইসলাম, আই উইল কাম ব্যাক এগেইন টু ইউ অল অফ ইউ। Before I go to the audience, I want to add a little information regarding the, I think the safety problem will be solved significantly if you relook at the factory from Dhaka to other adjacent areas. This is one thing. Another thing is that in an OECD meeting in June or July, I forgot the exact date, the almost all buyers have committed their they will be in Bangladesh, they will not shift order to other countries. So you don't need to be worried. So they are here, OECD in a meeting in Paris, in June or July, I forgot the exact date. They have committed, they will not, the ministers of many countries like USA, UK and Netherlands, they were there. There is another meeting, but they have already committed in June or July. I forgot the exact date, but they have committed. They will be here in Bangladesh. They will not shift order to other countries, although there are some disasters here last year. Thank you so much again. We will come back again to you. Now I will go to the audience.
Please.
Audience, please, if you have any question, mention your name and designation, then ask the question to our distinguished panelists. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Shauke. I'm from Daily New Age. I have a question to Atik Bhai. I guess one portion of Zahid Bhai's last question, what will be happening to the workers of the garments who are not in the alliance or not in the accord and they are in the shared buildings? What will be the status of these workers when their factories close down for the movement of the places? What will be the status?
Okay, I'm giving you the answer one by one. Yeah, there's the, sorry, Zahid bhai, I'm in portion bhule geslam. The thing is that if the factories is closed at this moment, as you know that the 19 factories has already been, 23 factories has already been closed due to the building safety issues, concern. And of course, the factories owners has paid the money already. And out of that factories, three factories are not member of alliance or accord. In Chittagong, there's a two factories, yeah. And Dhaka also two factories. But why they close? Because the building is not safe. And when the building is not safe, is the order is coming from the review committee. Who is the review committee? Is the government ministry of labor. The, you know, the newly appointed called the IG inspector general, yeah, of labor. He closed the factory.
Your member is also the member of the review committee.
Yeah, yeah. We are, Mr. Azim has the member. Yeah. Of, so we are saying with the
also the BKMA.
Member.
So
BKMA sometimes members. Sometimes they did not send their report to the review committee. Without sending report to review committee, they closed the factory. Accord doing like this.
No, but now of course now accord. It has everything has to be the review committee. So I'm giving the answer. So it is not that the owners are not paying. They are not the members of Accord and Alliance. So they have to pay. But I have a request to all of you. Say example, God forbid it, tomorrow my factories, they are saying I have to close the factory. So the as a distinguished audience also, I like to say, as an entrepreneur, I have to pay the salary for the workers. I have to pay the back-to-back liabilities for the all the bank liabilities. As an entrepreneur, I have to take all the back-to-back liabilities from the customs. As an entrepreneur, I have to pay all the dues. Then I cannot be alive. You better to shoot me on. This is the reality, because in our country we don't have any kind of exit policy. So I will request to the government also, and from this session also, please humble request to make a exit policy for the entrepreneur. All over the world, there is a bankruptcy rules. There's a chapter 11, chapter 7. You know that 15 years back, the Panam Airlines, the biggest airlines in the North American, and they closed the factory one day, not notice also. Morning, very early morning, they said they closed the factory because there's a policies of the bankruptcy. But in our country, we don't have. So I will request in this session, better we have to do the exit policy, because lots of things are coming. That's I'm saying that those are still thinking have a garments factory, they cannot sustain. They have to close the factory.
Thank you. If you have, please.
Yes, my name is Fariyat Hussain. I'm the head of research at the Daily Star. I have a question for Dr. Zahid Hussain, sir.
Yeah.
We know that more than 80% of our RMG exports are going towards the traditional markets, which is the North America and the EU. To what extent do you think this dependency makes us vulnerable, and what can we do about it? Thank you.
Well, I think these are huge markets, Europe and America. So I will not worry too much about the dependency on, because it's not like we are depending on Bhutan or Nepal or even Japan. So these are large area markets. Europe comprises of many different countries. But yes, I mean, diversifying outside these traditional markets, as you know, government already has a policy that if you penetrate markets outside North America and Europe, then you get cash subsidy, right? So we need to be exploring those possibilities. But as I said before, external problems are not really the binding problems that we are facing. Our destiny in the apparel sector is in our own hands. If we address the problems, the gas problem, for example, Atik was mentioning, the location problem, everybody has mentioned power and roads and access to port. If we solve this problem, I will bet my salary, annual salary, that the garment, and it's not a bad amount, it's the garment industry will perform.
Yes. Absolutely. Please.
I agree as well.
Question, please.
I have a question for Atik Bhai, Hatim Bhai, with special attention to the Export Promotion Bureau. The export strategies, the diversification of the markets like USA, Europe, we already have a very good hold on those markets, their export industry. What about the other markets like Latin America? Like, who makes the strategies? Like, you give the strategies to the Export Promotion Bureau, or the government comes up with the strategies? Like, okay, you go there, you go to Japan. Like, I think Bhai mentioned that China is also, or Hatim Bhai, I think you mentioned that China is a very big market. So how can Export Promotion Bureau back up the members of the BGMEA and BKMEA to go to China to, you know, I mean, to participate in trade shows and all those things? How?
Okay. I'm just saying, first of all, when we start the business in 1984, or very early 80s or 70s, on that time, we did not get any order either from Export Promotion Bureau. So it is our own creation, but it is, but we want working together, because you can see the early 80s Export Promotion Bureau, and if you see the late 20s Export Promotion Bureau, there's a lots of differences there. So now what we're doing? Now we have a few days back also we have a talk together, the how many countries we can do the export, which are the countries we have to give the more focusing. Despite of the market from Europe and America, like we are thinking that from BGMA also, we are going to take the, we are going to fare for the BRICS. Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa, even Australia, also these kind of things. So how we can do the penetrate? Then we said South Africa at this moment duty is 45%.
Yes.
No need to go to South Africa at this moment.
Yes.
Where the countries are less duty, we can go. The Russia is our big market. How many fairs we can do? Then we can talk with the Export Promotion Bureau. These kind of things. But you know, the when we'll do the business, we are not going to sit on the Export Promotion Bureau. Other Export Promotion Bureau we cannot dominate to us, and neither we can dominate to Export Promotion Bureau. It is completely individual track, individual railway line. So, and you can say the parallel, like the two train is going the two wheel as well. So Export Promotion is running on their way. We are, but entrepreneur, we have lots of countries you don't know also we are exporting. So it is completely independent.
In addition, I'd like to add, you know, the last few years we are working for the new market exploration with the help of the Export Promotion Bureau and GIZ also. And Japan, Russia, Latin America, we organized some Knit Expo also last 3 years in Russia, Moscow, and Tokyo. And recently we are going to China also, because you know the China will be the next big individual
big market.
China. So these are happening. We are doing a lot of we have a lot of program for the new market exploration.
Yeah.
And from the government side also, you know, there is an incentive also for new market exploration.
So sir, can you mention
another
the
thing
percentage?
Which was another thing which was very importantly marked by Mr. Kabir of the tourism, of the Bangladesh Tourism Board, is the branding of Bangladesh. I was at the magic show last month, and I saw the Bangladesh pavilion. I saw the other pavilions. I saw the China pavilion. I saw the, of course, all the countries were there, and they represented their pavilions, country pavilions. And Bangladesh pavilion was just in really very bold Bangladesh, that's it. It is a Bangladesh pavilion, very boldly written, that's it. There was no link to the, like as Mr. Kabir said, that it, why not beautiful Bangladesh? Why not?
Definitely, we like to actually.
Export Promotion Bureau goes there. I think somebody was there from the Export Promotion Bureau. If Export Promotion Bureau and the Bangladesh Tourism Board tie up, that you already had a booth over there. You had some guys at your booth. So the conclusion to Mr. Kabir's proposal is not there over here. Like, you know, we are here to conclude to something. So how do we really project Bangladesh in a proper and a beautiful way, not only in terms of, it's not a name, it's a country. Like portraying it more as a country than just a name.
Definitely. I like to mention that Mr. Kabir's proposal is very good. And we like to add his the beautiful Bangladesh, this slogan in our every in future program, future Knit Expo or any other program.
Great. I can just conclude one thing. You know, the very recently Delhi Star and Bangalink, you already started a campaign, the photo exhibition. The theme is the beautiful Bangladesh. It is the beautiful Bangladesh, the country branding. And also, I can add one point, that is Mr. Shahid already asked how we will get the new market, what is the trend. The Tariff Commission, they have their own research cell. They're always just finding out what is the trend, tariff trend, and the demand and the other things. And also our mission in abroad. We can get information from our mission abroad. When I was working in EPB, I was the director of international affairs, and I just used to collect information from our mission abroad. So in that, in the two sources, from Tariff Commission and mission abroad, we can get the new market and trend. And accordingly to those information from Export Promotion Bureau, we are used to organize to participate in the trade show.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kobir. You might have many questions, please.
I think...
Mention your name and designation, please.
I am Tarek from Bangladesh Textile Today. First of all, I would like to thank the organizer. In fact, the composition of the panel is really amazing. We are seeing very good blend of people from different parts. That's why the discussion, in fact, we are enjoying a lot. Especially the endings, you know, the addition of Bangladesh Tourism Board in the positive branding of Bangladesh. You know, what happened in 2013, I think it is very important for us to really look at the positive branding of Bangladesh. And to the BGMEA president, he has indicated something that his position is very important, as if it seems like a country. You know, he mentioned that 4.4 million people is in the industry. And that is the first P of McKinsey report also. So my question or my question to him that what is the plan with this first P in terms of capacity building? For example, NBR is giving some support, cutting down the tax at source to 0.3% from 0.8%. There is some advantage which is going to the industry. So is there any opportunity for the industries to invest that in the capacity building of the people, you know, those who are working in the sector?
Please ask your question, please.
Yes, that is my question. How do you look at, you know, on those opportunities, on those things, you know, how are you planning for capacity building of the people working in the industry? And you have mentioned that they are getting in at around $70 and with no skill, and you are investing behind them. But can you organize it in some other way, you know, to facilitate them?
Please. For the training?
Yes, for the training.
Yes. There are, already I mentioned, there are so many training program already we have taken with the help of the ADB. One training we will start with the next month. Maybe after Eid we will start. And within the next 3 years, we have 48,000 workers we will train. BGME will train 64,000.
Maybe you have some training center also.
Yes, already we organized some training center. One is already in Dhaka, already running. Narayanganj 2 running. Another 2 is going on. We organize. And Kumilla 1, Chittagong 2.
Yes, these are great initiatives. But can you imagine the amount in compared to 4.4 million? In fact, it's very big.
Yes.
In-house yes. training, you know, how this in-house training is being shaped, you know, how it is getting importance within the industries.
Actually, these 4.4 million workers, they have taken training from the industry. And in-house training, on-job duty, on-job training.
Thank you so much.
And this will be continued.
Thank you. Maybe we have
another small question for EPB. We have seen that garment sector has got a phenomenal growth amid all the problems and all. But in the textile area, especially jute and home textiles, it is TEXAPP, that's why I'm asking. How do you look at, you know, we didn't see any growth in home textiles and jute sector went down. So we had very strong export over there. In home textile, it is around 1 billion, and in jute, it is more than 1 billion. So how are you looking at in those sectors?
Sorry, your question?
In jute and home textile sector. Because last financial year, in home textile, there was no growth. And in jute, there was, in fact,
that means he wanted to ask you the question, what about the EPB has done for increasing the export of home textile and jute? Because jute, the prospect of jute is also very bright, because the use of natural fiber is increasing worldwide.
Yeah, yeah.
So what the EPB has done?
You know that the artificial fiber is very expanding. And the natural fiber, that means jute, is in very poor condition in the global market. We are trying to explore the jute sector to export raw jute. I'm sorry, I'm new in EPB. I don't know.
Thank you so much. We'll come back to the audience again after a few discussion with the distinguished panelist. Now we want to go another issue, very important issue. Someone has already mentioned the investment. New investors are not coming in the sector. There is another debate in investment, foreign investment in apparel sector. I will start with Zahid sir. Then we'll have opinion from both of you. Thank you.
I think one point I want to mention in the question that was raised is, what is the next garment?
Yeah.
I think we have a policy problem. And World Bank has been saying this repeatedly, and so I'm going to put that thought here, is that our trade policy, particularly the structure of custom duty and supplementary duty and the way we apply them, is heavily biased against exports. We call this anti-export bias. I was told by one footwear producer is that he prefers to sell footwear in the domestic market, even though there is demand for his footwear in foreign markets, because there is 125% total protection rate on import of footwear into Bangladesh. So it is more profitable to sell it in the local market than to sell it abroad.
You're criticizing the policies of the government?
I'm saying the trade policy, particularly the tariff and supplementary duty structure, and the way we impose them on import vis-a-vis domestic production has a huge bias against exports. Now you could ask, how come garment industry grew despite this trade policy?
Yeah.
But you have to keep in mind that garment industry was treated differently.
Yeah.
Right? So they didn't face this anti-export bias from this special bonded warehouse facility was given to garments, and they got to import inputs at world prices. Other exporters also have this facility, but they have to go to this DEDO office, duty exemption and drawback office, which is totally dysfunctional. So you pay your duty first, you export, and then you claim refund of the money. That doesn't work. In SBW, you don't pay, right? So this anti-export bias has to be removed if you want to find alternative to garments, if you want to diversify market and products.
Thank you so much. We were talking about investment in apparel sector by foreign investors and local investors.
Yes.
Thank you,
regarding,
Mr. Hatem.
Foreign investment, maybe Atik Bey also will supplement with me. But actually, we are inviting the foreign investment in our sector for the backward linkage industry.
Yeah.
You know, the only garments industry, we have sufficient entrepreneur in our country. And we are
sufficient entrepreneur, local entrepreneur.
Local sufficient entrepreneur. And we are getting money from our bank, you know, the high interest rate. We install our industry with high interest rate. If one foreigner will come in our country to invest only garment sector, maybe they are getting money only 1%, less than 2%, like that.
Yeah.
So this is unhealthy competition initially we have to face.
Yeah.
So that we are giving some restriction to invest only garment sector, but we like to welcome them with composite industry, backward linkage industry.
Backward linkage industry.
And also they will get the benefit, some benefit government given us, so they will take that benefit with a small investment. This is not allowed. We cannot allow.
Thank you so much, Mr. Atik, on foreign investment in apparel sector, because there is a debate over the last few years.
What Mr. Hatem was saying, correctly mentioning that actually that we need for the shirt, for the T-shirt, if they say that the foreign investors coming, then of course we are not giving them the welcoming to them rather than discouraging. So we are saying why not do to the value-added items?
Yeah.
The suit. The suit is Bangladesh is very less factories are doing the suit.
Special items.
The lingerie,
yeah.
Undergarments, swimwear. These are very much value-added products. But this is very much high-tech industry.
Yeah.
In Bangladesh, there's a very suit industry. Those are booked till next 10 years. But the knowledge of the suit, we don't know still. The if you're wearing the suit also, it is to wearing, it's that much easy. But to make it is not that much easy. It's really very high tech. And also we are saying, why not you come to the top to bottom?
Yeah.
Why they are going only that end product? Why not you start the beginning product? You do the textile, then you do the only the shirt factory. Now, it will be very much unparalleled.
Yeah.
If you are going to give only the shirt, we are not discouraging. We are saying encouraging, rather you do the full composite textile, so the more value-added can be in Bangladesh. Otherwise, of course, the debate is there. A few days back, lots of investors, they came from different countries.
Yeah.
They said, why you are stopping the UDs and all these things? Actually, we are saying we are not stopping the UDs and all these things. This is the competition. It has to be the healthy competition to all of us. Only you do the textile, please do it, but not only the garments or T-shirts or bottom.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
I have visited in the Young One factory in Chittagong.
Yeah.
What item they made, this is very expensive.
Yeah.
They are not actually our competitor.
Yeah.
So we like to invite like that industry.
High-end.
High-end industry, so that we can see them and we can understand. And after that, we will also go like that industry.
Thank you. We will go back to the audience again. Just before I ask Mr.
I have one question for question for Atik Bhai and Hatim Bhai. Keeping in loop the machinery importer Sohail, that Atik Bhai, Hatim Bhai, do you think that the machinery importers are in Bangladesh, they can bring in the latest equipment, and are you happy about the products and the latest technology they bring into Bangladesh, or you have to go abroad to see the latest machinery or something? So what do you expect out of the machinery importers, and what are the gridlocks over here that you face in importer machinery?
We are happy to see here in the exhibition what machine they take here. So we are happy, and we have seen lot of new technology machineries here.
So we have it right here in Bangladesh.
Actually, I'm just adding, definitely it is here because we are not running the machine. Our technician, they are running the machine. So in the factories, that's what I'm saying, is the industry now. The industrial engineer people, they can come. The production engineer people, they can come. The mechanics, they can come. And they can verify the whole things, and they are saying, sir, buy this machine. Already I got a few phone calls already from my people. I don't know, they are all are here. The bunch of group, they are all are here. So these kind of things are very much important because we need to, the cost of production, how we can reduce the cost of production, that's very important. So modern machine, high-tech machine, the more productivity is very important.
Scientific
very, very important.
Management.
Scientific
yeah.
management,
yeah.
absolutely.
Yeah.
So this is very
thank
much
you
important.
So much.
I'd like to add here that now it's in a global market. It's an open market. So if something happening in the worldwide, something, some development is there, it's automatically it's coming to the market,
yes,
actually.
Market, yes.
Yeah.
And it's as an honest company like us dealing with the capital machinery, it's our responsibility to bring it to the entrepreneurs and make them understand what benefit and what advantage they will get.
Do you face any gridlocks when you bring in the machines or something?
Okay, we are not bringing in any machines, actually.
Actually, so, actually by the factories.
Yes, yes.
Directly.
It's entrepreneurs, they're open the LC in favor of us. So it's coming.
So it's a smooth operation.
Yeah, but one problem we are facing in terms of providing a good service to our customer, which is spare parts. Because
spare parts,
that is the most important thing. Because we do not have any permission to bring any spare parts for our customers, though all these spare parts will be used for the 100% garments industries, export industries. But we cannot bring any spare parts. Even we bring the spare parts, we have to pay huge amount of duty, that because all these industries, they are getting 100% benefit.
I think you can put forward your thing to BKMEA, BGMEA, they all are here, and maybe they can take up the matter with the government.
Yes.
That's what this is all about.
If there is an synchronization to understand everybody, then...
Regarding spare parts import, we wrote so many letters to our honorable NBR people, NBR chairman also, to reduce the duty or withdraw the duty for the export-oriented industries. But still, we did not get it.
Thank you so much.
Let's ask for some comments. I would like to ask for comment by Mr. Karim.
Mr. Kobe?
Mr. Karim of the NBR.
Well, you know that if you import any capital machinery, our rate is a zero rate taxation, capital machinery. And regarding the spare parts, I think you can approach the chairman again in a body, and you can explain your problems to the NBR. Probably you fail to explain this issue adequately. Because NBR is always there to help this industry. We are very much eager to help you. We want this industry to flourish. So my opinion in this respect is that probably you could not explain it properly.
Okay, thank you very much. We hope you will support us regarding this issue.
Definitely.
Yeah, certainly. Thank you. Please.
I'm Shahjad Kabir, Joint Secretary Ministry of Commerce. I see about the export promotion of Bangladesh regarding RMG and others. Just I have got a question, and at the same time, I want to add, very recently I went to India and I visited our missions. There are two commercial councillors. One is in Delhi, another is Kolkata, one is commercial council, another is first secretary commerce. My question is that you are contributing much in the export sector, though you are serving in the garment sector. Have you got any touch with our commercial councillor or first secretary commercial, and what are the help or assistance you are getting from them? Because we are going to evaluate how the commercial councillors are performing their role in about for promotion of our export in garment sector and other sector. Thank you very much.
Question to?
My question is to you, to the president of BGM.
Well, thank you very much. This is a very important. See, today in the morning time, I've seen that the Korean ambassador was here, and Amir Hossein Amo, our industrial minister, ministry was there. So Korean ambassador was very eager, and he's requesting the Mr. Minister, please come to
come
see
to
the
to
Korean stall. See how the feelings they are for this one, because he sent it for Bangladesh. To how much machine he can sell it, how much machine he can give distribution, how many projects they can do it in Bangladesh. But very unfortunate that what we are doing all the posting for abroad, these are all very political. These are very political. Why not our government is giving the assignment and responsibility? You are going as a commercial counselor, bring this much of business. And this, you find the market. This is the basically what is the meaning of commercial counselor? They must give the target.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, beside the target, these are become all the political posts. So I will request that if there's a lots of responsibility of the commercial counselor, there is a lots of things they have to do it. And if they can do it, definitely we can achieve a lot of business and a lot of also buyers as well.
Yes.
Oh, then, please, microphone.
We have got in 17 countries 19 commercial councillors. Among them, two are first secretary commercials, And we already in a meeting, and already in the last month, we have given the target each and every commercial councillors and bus security command. So nobody will defy about that, yet they have no target. But my question is that, what about their involvement with the business bodies?
Okay,
are they getting positive rule from them or not?
But some countries, commercial, I must salute to them. Yes. I'm not some commercial
councillor of Bangladesh.
In Bangladesh, I don't want to give them mention, but those are really very good.
Yes.
And they are calling to us, hey, this much of buyer, did he contact with you? I am sending this one. Yeah. At this time, they are going. So we must salute to them. Yes. But some commercial counselor, 100 calls, they are not responsive like this way. So because they are... That's why I'm saying that,
Actually...
So that's why I'm saying that, of course, the commercial counselor, we are... going to Paris, a single country fair.
Yeah.
So we are talking a different time to the commercial counselor, and very much proactive and very much active. So we must give a thanks. So I will say that I just heard it from you that our government has given a target. If they cannot fulfill, so then everybody will work. Why not 20% will work and 80% will sitting idle? Why not 100% they will do the same thing for others commercial counselors they do?
Thank you very much.
I just want to add. উনি যেটা বললেন কিছু কিছু কমার্শিয়াল কাউন্সিলর কিন্তু অত্যন্ত ভালো কাজ করছেন, যেমন জাপান, রাশিয়া ইভেন, তারপরে ওয়াশিংটনে যিনি আছেন উনি, মানে কয়েকজন কিন্তু খুব ভালো কাজ করছেন। রাশিদুল ইসলাম ইন জাপান, থ্যাংক ইউ।
রিসেন্টলি একটা আমাদের সজীব স্যারের ইয়াতে এবং ফরেন মিনিস্ট্রি অন্যান্য মিনিস্ট্রি নিয়ে আমরা ইয়া করেছি, মিটিং করেছি, এবং তাদেরকে শুধু টার্গেট দেওয়া হয়নি, তাদের গাইডলাইনও দেওয়া হয়েছে এবং তাদেরকে প্রতি মাসে ইয়ে করতে হবে। সুতরাং জানাতে হবে তারা শুধু যে এই টার্গেটটা ফুলফিল করবে তা নয়, তারা প্রোঅ্যাক্টিভ হয়ে বিভিন্ন জায়গায় যাবে, এটা নিয়ে একেবারে খুব স্ট্রংলি একটা ইয়া দেওয়া হয়েছে।
যেমন আমি আমি একটা উদাহরণ দিই
এবং আমি আমি একটু বলি, এরকম যদি আপনাদের তরফ থেকে বা যে কোনো ইয়ার থেকে কোনো কমার্শিয়াল কাউন্সিলর আপনাদেরকে হেল্প করছে না বা আপনাদের কোঅপারেশন করছে না, ডেফিনেটলি আপনারা কমার্স মিনিস্ট্রিতে এবিভিকে আপনারা জানাবেন, আমরা সেখানে আমরা ইয়ে করবো, চেষ্টা করবো, ইনফর্ম করেন, আমরা এটাকে অবশ্যই আমরা এটাকে
এই ক্ষেত্রে আমাদের যেটা সবচেয়ে বেশি ইম্পর্টেন্ট কমার্শিয়াল কাউন্সিলরদের কাছ থেকে, যেমন আমাদের বেশ কিছু এক্সপোর্টার দীর্ঘদিন যাবৎ বিভিন্ন রকমের আনফেয়ার প্র্যাকটিস, বায়ারদের আনফেয়ার প্র্যাকটিসের কারণে, আনএথিক্যাল বিজনেস প্র্যাকটিসের কারণে তারা সাফার করছে। যেমন মাল নিয়ে পয়সা দিচ্ছে না, টাকা দিচ্ছে না, ওই এখান থেকে মাল ইন্সপেকশন করে নিচে পোর্টে ফেলে রেখে এখন বলছে তুমি 50% ডিসকাউন্ট দাও। এই যে আনএথিক্যাল বিজনেস প্র্যাকটিস, এগুলো নিয়ে আমরা সেভারাল টাইম ওখানকার কমার্শিয়াল কাউন্সিলরদেরকে আমরা বলেছি, ইয়েস, বাট এই বিষয়গুলি তারা ওখানে হেল্প করতে পারে, বাট আমরা এখনো এই এই ধরনের হেল্পগুলি আমরা পাচ্ছি।
থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ আই উইল টেক টু কোশ্চেন মোর টু কোশ্চেন থ্যাংক ইউ
ভেরি মাচ। I am trying to long time to speak. question.
Please mention your name and designation.
My name is Probir Kantidas. I am managing partner of Lot Incorporate. Actually, this is a timely initiative of CEMS-Global and Delister. From the discussion, it is understood the apparel industry is a success sector in Bangladesh. And there is a lot of discussions and all are fruitful discussion, and it's proved that the industry is going positively. Bangladesh is going positively, but there is some negative.
Please, your question, please.
Yes, I am come to my question. I am question under the challenges of your first discussion. The challenges, the lot of challenges you have discussed, but though this apparel sector is going perfectly and they overcome the challenges for 2013, it proves this, everything is going positively. But from the discussion and also some panelists also point out the image matters. I would like to point out, I have two questions. The apparel leaders, the BGMEA president and BKMEA president, that I think you have a lot of activities, lot of compliance activities you are going for the welfare of for the worker of your industry, as well as you have a lot of development issues. But I would like to know what sorts of steps you have taken or you are going to take to showcase your activities and development prospect to the foreign counterpart as well as local counterpart. This is my first question. Then another question, the Mr. Atik President BGMEA, deliberation, he pointed out that the apparel industry, this is not factory now. Apparel now is industry. I would like to know from him the what is the criteria behind this. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Well, first I'm giving the probable answer.